Instagram, like it or not, has turned into one of the biggest social media platforms out there. Almost everybody who is somebody is on there, and anybody who wants to become somebody is trying to grow there. But the thing about Instagram is that it is an oddball when it comes to standards. As you already know, Instagram is a mobile platform which mostly insists on scrolling down. Since you generally scroll in the portrait mode, aspect ratios should change based on that. So as a result, Instagram, while it still supports 16:9, has made 1.91:1, 1:1, and 4:5 as its preferred aspect ratios. That 1.91:1 is so close to being 2:1, or as mobile manufacturers like to call it, 18:9. But no, they don't feel like giving us a number that is easy to remember or even pronounce. Add to that the fact that Instagram does not support 4K or 1080p, not even 720p. The maximum supported resolution on Instagram videos is 640x640, so that makes Instagram one hell of a platform to export videos for. Let's see what we got. Hello, Premiere. The first thing we have to do is creating a new sequence. File, new sequence. Now we go to the settings tabs, and in editing mode we will choose custom. Time base will be 23.976. Now for the resolution, I highly suggest using 1080x1350, which is a 4:5 aspect ratio. This aspect ratio not only will fill the phone screen as much as possible, but will also give us more real estate to work with. Also, if you are trying to make content for your Instagram stories, you can go for 1080x1920, which is a rotated Full HD video with the aspect ratio of 9:16. Okay, pixel will be a square, and for fields, we will choose no fields. The rest is fine and needs no change. So we will be going to save this as a preset for future use. I'm gonna name it Instagram 4:5. So you can see the aspect here is already set to 4:5. So I'm gonna import the video into my timeline. If you are going to upload this video as a post on your Instagram page, then it cannot be longer than 60 seconds. As you can see, there are black bars on top and bottom of the screen. One way to solve this is to come to the effects control panel and change the scale to fill in the black parts. That can work for videos where there are not much important stuff in the margin of the video. But the method I prefer to use is like this. I'm going to make a copy of the video in the timeline and stack them on top of each other. Then I will choose the bottom one and scale it up to fill in the background. Now I'm going to the effects panel and choose Gaussian blur. As you must have guessed by now, I'm creating a blurry duplicate in the background, which is much cooler than the black bars and cropped in videos. But again, it is all about taste and style of your video. Do what you feel is best for your content. Now that's all done, we are going to export our video. File, export, media. Format is going to be H.264, and for preset, for now, I will choose match source high bitrate. All you need to change here is bitrate settings. A good bitrate for Instagram videos is around 2.5 up to 4. So I'm gonna choose CBR and set target bitrate to 2.5. A thing to keep in mind is to keep an eye on estimated file size. The general consensus is that for a 60-second video, the size should be around 20 megabytes. And the best option to tweak for reaching that number is bitrate. Move it back and forth until you hit that 20 sweet spot. All that's left is to click on Use Maximum Render Quality and either hit Export or Cool. If any of these exporting settings was confusing to you, you can check my other video that talks about all the exporting settings. Hope this video was a good help. Be sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon for our future updates. Best of luck and bye. Almost everybody who is somebody has a handle in there. Almost everybody who is somebody is there, and anybody who wants to becomes.